all of you who are, you know, come just to be part of this evening, forgive us. We, people who have worked with Dubey are a kind of a clan, okay? And we have these, you know, in jokes, and we laugh at things that you might think are completely unfunny. So do remember that this is the first time we are actually doing this out like this in the public space. And it's fantastic to have all of you, but we are also a bit nervous about that. Secondly, we are, you know, as you've been hearing now for the last, I don't know, for the last 3 months, theater people complaining that we are essentially live performers, right? And the online space is really strange for us. Right now, I can see myself. I can't see anybody else. And this is the weirdest experience for anybody on stage, just to see yourself. So we are going to try and do our best. We have been trying to deal with the technology. I think we've got it more or less fixed. Okay, we'll try and do our best. So just forgive any of the glitches. Very quickly, it's wonderful. We have lots of people here from theater, people who were very close to Dubey. In fact, almost like Dubey's family in many ways. For instance, I noticed that Meera Benegal, Shyam and Pia Benegal are here with us this evening. Nasir is here. Ratna is coming, joining us in a little while. Akash is here. These are all people who are very, very close to Dubey, like family. And thank you very much for being here. So it's a very special and quite an emotional evening for us. Just a little bit of background. Dubey passed away on the 25th of December, 2011. That's several years ago. And he left behind really almost, first of all, he left behind a huge impact on the contemporary Indian theatre scene. And also an impact on almost three generations of theatre practitioners, you know, actors, directors, the works. We are a fairly large group of people who have been close to him, who have been sort of influenced by him. And one of the things that we learned from him was not to be sentimental and, get on with it. So in fact, we had a large get together a few days after he passed on. He had been in coma for almost 2 months, and a few days after he passed on, we had this big gathering at Prithvi Theatre, you know, about 300 of us squeezed into that space. And the only rule that was there was that nobody is going to say anything emotional, sad, cry, etc. We were just going to celebrate his memory. And it was fantastic. And that's what we've done all these years. We've just celebrated his memory. 13th of July is the day he was born. So that's the day we celebrate always. 25th of December is the day he passed on, and we also do something on that day. So initially, we used to just meet and share stories. And Dubey was such an eccentric and, you know, and so many idiosyncrasies that everybody who has dealt with him has a favorite Dubey story. We can write a, you know, three volumes on Dubey stories. So, of course, it kept us in splits. But, one of the things that Dubey used to also say is that stop talking, get on and start working on the play, you know, stop discussing things, just do. So from the next year onwards, we started dealing with themes that would have excited him. You know, that he was very fond of new writing. So we'd do something on new writing, or we'd, you know, get a bunch of young theater people, because he really loved working with young people and he really influenced a lot of young people. So we'd get them together and get them to talk about their lives, what their work is, or just generally talking about theater, because that's what he really loved, talking about theater. This year, the theme is slightly different, but it's completely in character with what Dubey would have loved. But before we do that, I just want to say very quickly that we have two or three people here who were, again, very close to Dubey, very close to many of us, who also share the same birthday. So Astad Debu is here with us. Happy birthday, Astad. Lovely to have you on this particular day. And Sarika Singh, I don't know if she's here today. But
yes, she's here.
She is here, Sarika. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, Sarika.
Sarika was very close to Dubey. She spent hours and hours and evenings taking down dictation of all his crazy scripts. She needs a special, applause for just doing that. And lovely to have you, Sarika. So, Dubey was a playwright's director, though, of course, many playwrights fought with him because they felt that he kind of messed with their scripts too much. But but he also encouraged playwrights. He's the one who actually introduced some very, very important playwrights to the theater scene. But Dubey was also an actor's director. And I would say that he pampered his actresses, okay, or his women actors, whatever the politically correct thing is to say. all of us have spent time after rehearsals, after a late rehearsal or after a late performance, dropping an actress home because she had to reach home safely. And this is one of the rules that he used to follow. And he was tough on them, of course, but he nurtured them very carefully. Also, in his own plays, female characters always were very strong. Of course, you would say that a playwright writes the character, and what does the director got to do? But actually, it's the way a director deals with, you know, an actor, a character, that makes a huge difference. And you know, sometimes Dubey would say that, you know, why would I want a weak character in my play? It doesn't work for my play to have a weak character. Whatever the reason may be, his women were always very strong characters. So we said, let's combine the two things, get in a group of actresses. And we have, you know, 13 actresses here today. Actually, 11 in person and 2 on video. And each of them is going to do a short piece, 3.5 minutes, 4 minutes, from a text that they have chosen. That sort of resonates with them. And most of these characters that they will read from are women. And we hope that they will also tell us why they particularly chose that text. So I think we should just go right ahead now. Let's start the evening with Ashwini Giri. Ashwini Giri is an actor from Pune. She's trained at the National School of Drama, and she worked with Dubey when she was quite young. So Ashwini, maybe you should unmute yourself first. Yeah. No, it was a mic mute. Hi. Okay. Yeah. So can you just tell us, Ashwini, tu kadhi Dubey barobar kaam kelela ani kutla as piece karte tu as?
Me first year to third year. Majha college sa 3 varsha ni tenchyavar kaam kela. Ani 3 varsha salak tense workshops Maharashtriya kalopasat ni ghetle hote. आणि त्यांच्यावर काम करता करता आयुष्यात पहिल्यांदाच हा कवितांचा कुसुमाग्रजांच्या कवितांचा कार्यक्रम त्यांच्यावर आम्ही तयार केला होता. आणि फार उत्तम अशी ती प्रोसेस होती, कारण स्वतःचा व्हॉइस काय आहे हेही कळत नव्हतं. दुबेजींमुळे नाटक करणं, स्वतःच्या अगोदर काम करणं आणि मग एनएसडीला जाणं हे मी केलं आणि आता मी इथे आहे.
ओके, तो आता आज काय कुठलं पीस करणार
आहे? धर्मवीर भारतीचं नाटक आहे अंधायु. जेव्हा आमचे वर्कशॉप पुण्यात चालत होते तेव्हा या नाटकाबद्दल मला दुबेजींकडनं कळलं. तेव्हा ते नाटक, ती भाषा, धर्मवीर भारतींची भाषा, दुबेजींचा तो परफॉर्मन्स, याने मी खूप प्रभावित झाले आणि ते नाटक मला आजही प्रभावित करतं. म्हणून त्याच्यातला गांधारी आणि कृष्णाचा संवाद मी सगळ्यांसमोर सादर करणार आहे.
ठीक आहे, ओके, लवली, करा.
तो वो पड़ा है कंकाल मेरे पुत्र का, किया है ये सब कुछ कृष्ण तुमने किया है यह. सुनो कृष्ण सुनो, आज तुम भी सुनो. मैं तपस्विनी गांधारी अपने सारे जीवन के पुण्यों का, अपने सारे पिछले जन्मों के पुण्यों का बल लेकर कहती हूं, सुनो. यदि तुम चाहते तो रुक सकता था युद्ध यह. मैंने प्रसव नहीं किया था कंकाल वह, इंगित पर तुम्हारे ही भीम ने अधर्म किया. क्यों नहीं वो शाप तुमने दिया भीम को, जो तुमने दिया निरपराध अश्वत्थामा को. तुमने किया है प्रभुता का दुरुपयोग. यदि मेरी सेवा में बल है, संचित तप में धर्म है, तो सुनो कृष्ण सुनो. प्रभु हो या परात्पर, कुछ भी हो, सारा तुम्हारा वंश इसी तरह पागल कुत्तों की तरह एक दूसरे को परस्पर फाड़ खाएगा. तुम खुद उनका विनाश करके कई वर्षों बाद किसी घने जंगल में एक साधारण व्याध के हाथों मारे जाओगे. प्रभु हो, मारे जाओगे पशुओं की तरह. माता, प्रभु हूं या परात्पर, पर पुत्र हूं तुम्हारा, तुम माता हो मैंने अर्जुन से कहा, सारे तुम्हारे कर्मों का पाप पुण्य योग क्षेम मैं वहन करूंगा अपने कंधों पर। 18 दिनों के इस भीषण संग्राम में कोई नहीं, केवल मैं ही मरा हूं करोड़ों बार। जितनी बार जो भी सैनिक भूमिशाही हुआ वो कोई नहीं था, मैं ही था। गिरता था घायल होकर जो युद्ध भूमि में, अश्वत्थामा के अंगों से रक्त पीप स्वेद बनकर मैं ही बहूंगा युग युगांतर तक। जीवन हूं मैं तो मृत्यु भी तो मैं ही हूं मां। शाप ये तुम्हारा स्वीकार है। ये क्या किया तुमने, ये क्या किया तुम? रोई नहीं मैं अपने 100 पुत्रों के लिए। कृष्ण तुम पर मेरी ममता आगाध है, कर देते ये शाप तुम मेरा अस्वीकार तो क्या मुझे दुख होता। मैं थी निराश, कटु थी, पुत्र ही ना थी। माता ऐसा मत कहो, जब तक मैं जीवित हूं पुत्रहीना नहीं हो तुम। प्रभु हूं या परात्पर, पर पुत्र हूं तुम्हारा, तुम माता हो। ये मैंने क्या किया विदुर, ये मैंने क्या किया, ये मैंने क्या किया विदुर, ये मैंने क्या किया।
Oh, that was beautiful, wonderful. It's such a powerful piece, such a powerful piece.
Thank you.
All right. You know, in the early 60s, there was a place called the Bhulabhai Desai Memorial Center, where Dubey used to, with other people, there were several people who worked there. And Dubey was very young, and he was sort of trying to posit a sound, kind of a counter to the English language theater that was happening. And he decided to do a play by Jean-Paul Sartre. It's called No Exit, or sometimes, you know, in some translations called In Camera. He wanted to do that in Hindi, in Urdu, in the Hindustani, as Band Darwaze. And he cast a young actress who had just come in from RADA in London, Alaknanda Samarth, in that part. And the play was done, Alaknanda Samarth, Sulabha Deshpande, also a very well-known actor, and Dubey himself, three characters. There are three characters in that play. And it's a very, very, you know, typical Sartre kind of text. These three characters are suddenly find themselves in a strange waiting room. And then they discover that actually they are dead, and they are going to be in this waiting room for eternity. And they have just the three of themselves for company. And it kind of illustrates Sartre's famous thought that, you know, hell is other people. And Alaknanda was cast to play one of the women, Estelle. Alaknanda lives in London, and she's not terribly good with technology, but we convinced her to actually send a voice recording of a bit of a reading. So I'm going to actually play that with a few photographs from the production that we managed to get hold of. I'm going to share the screen right now. Yeah. Ashwini, there are lots of comments coming, talking about how wonderful your piece was. So do have a look at that while I share the screen. And here we are. That's Alaknanda. And let me go into full screen.
And this is Alak. Hi, everybody. I'm in London. And, you know, thanks, Sunil, for remembering me. And let us remember Dubey. July the 13th. So happy birthday, Dubey. Vanda Raje has, as Mahesh Elkunswar said to me the other day or emailed me in connection with something else, he said, you know, I didn't see Vanda Raje, but it has taken the status of a legend in Indian theatre. So it is a phenomenon, and here's to Dubey. So I've got a speech in English. We did it in Urdu. I've got a speech that I played as Estelle. So here's Estelle. You mine? Oh, that's good. But which of you two would dare to call me his glancing stream, his crystal girl? You know too much about me. You know I'm rotten through and through. Peter, dear, think of me. Fix your thoughts on me and save me. All the time you're thinking, my glancing stream, my crystal girl, I'm only half there. I'm only half wicked. And half of me is down there with you, clean and bright and crystal clear as running water. Oh, just look at her face. All scarlet like a tomato. No, it's absurd. We've laughed at her together, you and I, often and often and often. What's that tune? I always loved it. Yes. The St. Louis Blues. All right. Dance away. Dance away. Garcin, I wish you could see her. You'd die of laughing. Only she'll never know I see her. Yes, I see you, Olga, with your hair all anyhow. And you do look a dupe, my dear. Oh, now you're treading on his toes. It's a scream. Hurry up, quicker, quicker. He's dragging her along, bundling her round and round. It's too ghastly. He always said I was so light. He loved to dance with me. She's dancing as she speaks. I tell you, Olga, I can see you. No, she doesn't care. She's dancing through my gaze. What's that? What's that you said? Our poor dear Estelle. Oh, don't be such a humbug. You didn't even shed a tear at the funeral. And she has the nerve to talk to him about her poor dear friend Estelle. How dare she discuss me with Peter? Now then, keep time. She never could dance and talk at once. Oh, what's that? No, 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 don't tell him, please, please don't tell him. You can keep him, do what you like with him, but please don't tell him about that. She stopped dancing. All right. You can have him now. Isn't it foul, Garcia? She's stolen everything. About Roger, my trip to Switzerland, the baby. Paul Estelle wasn't exactly, no, I wasn't exactly true enough. He's looking grave, shaking his head. But he doesn't seem so very much surprised. Not what one would expect. Keep him then. I won't haggle with you over his long eyelashes, his pretty girlish face. They're yours for the asking. His glancing stream, his crystal, well, the crystal's shattered into bits. Poor Estelle. Dance, dance, dance. On with it. But do keep time. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. How I'd love to go down to the earth for just a moment and dance with him again. She dances again for some moments. The music's growing fainter. They've turned down the lights. Like they do for a tango. Why are they playing so softly? Louder, please, I can't hear. It's so far away, so far away. I can't hear a sound. She stops dancing. All over. It's the end. The earth has left me. Dugasa, don't turn from me. Please. Take me in your arms.
So that was a glimpse of Alaknanda Samarth. She became quite a legend in Bombay after this particular play. Everybody was talking about Bandarwaze and about Alaknanda. Alaknanda has been doing a lot of very interesting work. She works mainly with small experimental theatre companies in England. And she's done a fair interesting kind of, you know, installation art and performance art kind of work. Let's move on. We have Sonali Kulkarni. Again, someone who's worked very closely with Dubey from her college days, I would think, or perhaps even school days. Sonali and Ashwini actually worked together with Dubey on one production. So they're both the Pune girls. Sonali, would you like to come on and just tell us what you're planning to do? Oh, there you are. You look gorgeous as usual.
I haven't done.
You're fine. Yes, you're absolutely fine. Go on.
I was just saying that thank you for the compliment, but I'm not able to get over with how beautiful Alaknanda is, how gorgeous, how breathtakingly beautiful she is.
Yeah, yeah.
Overwhelming. And Dubeji also, young Dubeji, seeing both of them. I think I have forgotten what I wanted to do, but let me get back myself.
Yeah, yeah. They did a film together called Aparichay Ke Vindhyachal, which you should see. They do this song and dance sequence, and she's just incredibly hot.
We have to bribe you, Sunil, because I know you have some extraordinary footage of Dubey's of variety of his work. So, from Ram Naam Satya Hai to that first original film, we want you to is it for us. Coming back to my performance today, I always wanted to approach Shantata Court Salu Hai. I have seen the monologue in variety of one act. Mono acting competitions during my college days, but I never dared to touch Shantata, because for me that play is a legend. Teamwork between Dubeji and Tendulkar was legendary, so I always feared now that Dubeji is not watching me, I am trying to do Benare. Unfortunately, in last 2-3 days I couldn't get hold of Hindi script of Shantata Court Jari Hai. So I have the Marathi script, Marathi Natak. I have tried to learn my lines from that. So
lovely. Marathi is the original language of that script. In any case, we'd love to hear it. Carry on.
Thank you. Thank you. Raj is going to help me with my cue. Rajeshri. Okay.
All right.
If you can unmute her.
Is Rajeshri around? I think Rajeshri has not been able to get in. She has
problem.
Some technical problem.
I'll start on my own.
Yeah? Okay, carry on.
Good. Push. Kitti varsha kai chhan ale galyashi ek ek vadal datli chhatit pranantik akrosh dhale पण ओठ घेतले घट्ट मिटून जेव्हा शब्दांच्या मोठमोठ्या लाटा येऊन धडका देत ओठांवर तेव्हाच भवतालची सारी माणसं कशी बालबुद्धी वेडी उत्तू वाटत माझा असलेला माणूस धरून सारी माणसं वाटायचं की या सर्वांना फक्त पोट भरून हसून घ्यावं फक्त आणि रडून रडून आतडी पिळवटायची छाती फुटेल तर बरं असं वाटायचं जीव नकोसा व्हायचा तो गेला नाही म्हणजे त्याचं महत्व कळतं जगण्याचं महत्व कळतं सुख कळतं येणारा प्रत्येक क्षण कसा नवा अपूर्वाईचा वाटतो आपणच आपल्याला नवे होतो आकाश पक्षी ढग एखाद्या वटलेला झाडाचा हलकीच डोकावणारा एकच भाग खिडकीचा हलता पडदा नि भोवतालची शांतता नि लांबचे बारीक सारीक एक एक आवाज नि इस्पितळातला औषधांचा दर्प तो सुद्धा कसा जीवनाने रसरसलेला वाटतो जीवन तणू फेर धरून आपल्या भोवती आपल्या एकट्यासाठी गातय असं वाटत हुकलेल्या आत्महत्येतला आनंद फार मोठा असतो जगण्याच्या वेदनेहून मोठा प्राण उधळावा तेव्हा तो असल्याचा आनंद लक्षात येतो प्राण प्राणापलीकडे जपावा तर तो उधळण्याच्या लायकीचा आहे हे लक्षात येतो मजा आहे नाही. काही पुरत नाही, पुन्हा पुन्हा तेच आणि तसच. जीवन हे असं आहे, जीवन हे अमुक आहे, जीवन म्हणजे तमुक आहे, जीवन म्हणजे तेरे तेरे फायदे देणारे ग्रंथ आहे, जीवन म्हणजे स्वतःलाच डंख करणारा महाविषारी सर्प आहे, जीवन म्हणजे विश्वासघात आहे, जीवन म्हणजे प्रतारणा आहे, जीवन म्हणजे नशा आहे, जीवन म्हणजे रखडपट्टी आहे, जीवन म्हणजे काहीतरी आहे असं काहीच नाही आणि काहीतरीच आहे असंही काही नाही. मिलॉर्ड, जीवन ही एक महाभयंकर गोष्ट आहे. जीवनाला फाशी दिलाच पाहिजे. न जीवनम जीवनम अर्हति. जीवनाची चौकशी करून त्याला नोकरीवरून काढून टाकलं पाहिजे. का मी माझ्या कामात कुचराई केली? मी जीव ओतून माझ्या पोरांच्यात रमत आले, त्यांना शिकवत आले आले ना. Done.
Lovely. Thank you. Thank you so much, Sonali. Do you know that Dubey actually never directed the stage version of Shantata? He just made the film. And it was in fact the first major film that he directed. A lot of people say it was the beginning of the new wave in Marathi. It was also an early film for Govind Nihalani and a lot of people at that time.
He shot it. We never got to see any footage of the play. I have never tried to Google or tried to watch it on YouTube either. So for us, only in memories.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Okay, wonderful. Thank you so much. We are going to move ahead now. Lots of messages coming in for you from the chat window, Sonali. Everybody appreciates that. Thank you so much. So I'm going to ask Chitra Palekar to join us now. Chitra again is a very, very old associate of Dubey's, she's going to actually do a piece from a very interesting play that not many of us know about, and actually in quite interesting circumstances. So Chitra, why don't you just tell us about what you're doing and why you're doing that?
I'm going to read a poem from Ramesh Bakshi's play, Devyani Ka Kehna Hai. I don't think many from this generation know about the play. Well, Dubey and I acted in it in 1975. He was Sadhan and I was Devyani. And the introduction I've written because, frankly, my memory is a bit shaky nowadays. Devyani is a very strong woman and a highly liberated woman. In this play, she questions the traditional roles of a woman, like, you know, daughter, wife, everything, sister, all those. And the fun thing is that in this play, she experiments with various man-woman relationships. She acts like a wife, she acts like a prostitute, and she is actually just a lover of Sadhan, you know. And she does all this. And it was a very bold and powerful role for me. And it was way ahead of 1975. So I remember it fondly even now. But Sunil, you know, there is a very, very important reason why I've chosen the play. Not only because of Devyani's character or a strong role.
Yeah.
It is because this is the play which Dubey had not directed. He was only an actor. The director was Shama Zaidi.
Yep. And it was an IPTA production.
Yeah. And it was an IPTA production and not theater unit. That was very important for me. Because then in the rehearsals, Dubey could not scream at me. He was only an actor like me. So he could not fire me. He could not throw me out of the play as he had done many times before. So you can imagine how important and how beautiful this place. It's a very, very special place for me.
Yes, I can now completely understand and completely empathize with your sentiments on this. And I'm sure a lot of people here completely understand.
I'm sure many, many actresses, they may not be thrown out, yeah, but the other things may apply to most of his actresses, I think.
Sure. Go right ahead. Thank you.
Okay, I'll just now read from the poem, okay? फिर से मैं बिस्तर से I'll start again. फिर से मैं बिस्तर में उतारे कपड़े फिर से पहन लूंगी और सारे संबंधों को क्रॉस करती हुई लंबे रास्ते पर निकल जाऊंगी. अपने शरीर पर दांतों नाखूनों जोर जबरदस्तियों के हरे निशान लेकर मैं तुम्हारे मोहल्ले में से गुजरती हुई शहर भर में भटकना पसंद करूंगी. मेरे लिए ये कभी नहीं होगा कि जिसके साथ दोपहर काटी, जिसके साथ शाम की चाय पी, जिसके साथ अंधेरे में अंधेरे को खोजा, उसके साथ स्वयंवर रचाऊं, कस्मे खाऊं, प्रतिबद्धता ढोऊं. I'm sorry, साधन, मैं तुम्हें अपनी अंतिम पसंद नहीं समझती, बिल्कुल नहीं समझती. मैं तुम्हारी सप्तपदी को एक तरह की चहलकदमी समझती हूँ, तुम्हारे अग्निहोत्र को सिगड़ी जलने का पूर्वाभ्यास, अपने पत्नी नाम को महज एक सीजनल टिकट और तुम्हारे दर्शन ग्रंथों को कबाड़ी के लिए सुरक्षित रखा ढेर. श्वेत केतु ने ये कहा था, वो कहा था, कहा होगा अपनी माँ के लिए, अपने पिता के लिए, मैं उसे कानून नहीं मानती. मैं तुम्हारी सूक्तियों, आर्ष वचनों, संदर्भों, इतिवृत्तों से, आशीर्वादों से एकदम बोर हो गई हूँ, साधन, बोर हो गई हूँ. मैंने बोर होकर चादर फाड़ डाली है, मैंने बोर होकर बिस्तर बदल डाले हैं, बोर होकर दीवार से सर टकरा लिया है. लेकिन लेकिन मैं अपनी ताकत का सामना करूंगी और अंतिम तत्व या बुद्ध ज्ञान भले न मिले, एक बार सारे वेद वाक्यों को पीट कर ही पीछे रहूंगी. मेरी मुराद छोटी सी है साधन, मैं सारी परंपरा को अपने सामने पराजित हकलाती हुई देखना चाहती हूँ. आखिर खुले नीले आसमान में मुक्त निर्बंध उड़ने और उड़ते रहने की इच्छा, ये देवयानी का उपनाम है. Thank you.
Wow, wonderful, beautiful. That was really very, very nice.
I enjoyed, Sunil, is that this was in 1975.
Yes, you know, absolutely.
And just imagine, it was so bold that during the rehearsals, I was told that many, many actresses, I won't name, they refused the role because they were worried about the image. So, I mean, I've heard about it. That's it. So, thank you so much.
All right. Thank you. Lovely. Thank you so much, Chitra. Thank you so much. You know, I have a photograph somewhere of this. I'm going to try and look for it and maybe show it later on. Just tell me, was Dubey a good romantic actor? I mean, was it nice working with her?
You're asking me?
Yes, I'm asking you, Chitra.
Frankly, I always preferred Dubey as a director to being an actor.
No, I'm asking, was he a good romantic actor? Come answer the question.
Romantic actor? Oh, well, I really don't know. But I think in Devyani, we had a lot of fun because he was not a director. So I think he was very relaxed.
Right.
You know what I mean?
I think what she's saying was he was a nice romantic actor. Okay, we'll leave it at that. Thank you so much. All right. So, you know, Dubey, as I told you earlier.
And Shama was very gentle, you know, Sunil. She was a very lovely director.
Yeah, and well, so, I don't know if Shama is here today. Shama, if you're here, lovely to have you. And I'm so glad we could do a piece out of Devyani Ka Kehna. I believe we didn't do enough shows of that play. I think it's something that really needs to be.
No, Nina told me that she saw in Bal Gandhara because I was trying to recollect. I couldn't even. And I think in Bhai Das. You know, in 75, there was no Prithvi. There was no, I mean, I don't remember doing in Tejpal. But no, even this other Apna Chabil Das had just started.
Sure.
But this production needed a proper stage, I think. That's how Shama had visualized.
I saw it at Chabil Das, actually. Yeah.
Oh, I see.
All right. Okay, let's carry on. So Dubey, as I told you, you know, used to have these long you know, fights with playwrights. He loved playwrights, and he also you know, took control of their texts. And one of the playwrights, I think, who may be here today actually, told Dubey, you know, if you are so particular about the play the way you want it, why don't you write your own damn play? So Dubey took that as a challenge, and he went and wrote Sambhog Se Sanyasak, which is this crazy mythological play which talks about sex.
Don't I mean, worry. You know, we don't put a message. Yes.
Yeah, it just.
I want to send a message to.
I can hear somebody.
You can call her.
Yeah. All right. So it is crazy play, and it talks about sex in the land of Apsaras and Gandharus. So it's got this kind of freaky mix between the old and the new. And in 1975, we did that production, and there were some really very, very, I mean, people who acted in that production today have gone on to become big names in the world of theater and cinema. I think at least five or six productions of that play were done. So many actors worked in Sambhog Se Sanyasak. One of them was Nandita Aras, who's here with us today. Nandita started working with Dubey very young, and she has a particular attachment to this play. So I'd ask Nandita to go right ahead and talk about it. And yeah, go ahead, Nandita. Oh, there you are. Hi, hi. Lovely. Yeah, you are unmuted now.
Okay. So I started working with Dubey in 71 in Haivadan as Balak. And then from 80 to 86, I did about 11 plays, acted in 11 plays with him, and then assisted him in a couple of plays. And then he let me do Aranya as a director, Aranya in theater unit, which was a big surprise to me. So today, as you mentioned, I'm going to do Sambhog Se Sanyasak, a scene between Gandharva Sen and Basanti, which I'll be playing. And as you said, a lot of people have done Sambhog Se Sanyasak, so I thought it would be a fun, after following all of the beautiful pieces that were done before, this would be just a fun memory that we can all enjoy. But there's another reason I thought this would be a good play to do, a good piece to do, because as Sunil, you mentioned that all the characters in Dubey's plays are very powerful women. And in Sambhog Se Sanyasak, the play that he has written, the central female character, Basanti, is a pativrata who begs for a child from a man who disdains her, who happened to be her husband in the previous, in Swargaloka. So it's kind of, but when you see the Basanti is so because she needs to be so for the plot to happen. And even there, Dubey has managed to insert in Basanti a voice that is she, despite this pativrata and a desire, she feels that she will only be fulfilled if she can have a child from this man who disdains her. So even there, wherever Basanti gets a chance, she talks about the right of a woman, a fundamental right that a woman has to choose the father of her child. So it's a comedy, Sambhog Se Sanyasak. One of the reasons I'm doing it is because we did that play so many times that those were the lines that I kind of remember after 30 years. So the scene is between Gandharva Sen and Basanti. And Gandharva Sen thinks that he's talking to Rajkumari, who he's attracted to. And he complains about Basanti, the wicked maid, who he believes has not delivered his love letters to Rajkumari. So he is questioning Basanti, and it is actually Basanti who is standing there in a princely attire and not Rajkumari. So that is the scene for those. There are people here who haven't probably participated in Sambhog Se Sanyasak.
That's fine. Go ahead.
Yeah. All right. पत्र पहुंचाए हैं राजकुमार बिना नागे के पूरी ईमानदारी से पहुंचाए हैं राजकुमारी के लिए आपके पत्र पहुंचा कर तो मेरी ये हालत हो गई है कि पूरी लाज शर्म छोड़कर कोई ना कोई बहाना बनाकर आपके सामने आ पड़ती हूं और आप है कि जाने दीजिए क्यों आपको वही बातें सुनाकर तंग करूं जो आप सुन चुके हैं, जिनके सुनते ही आप पत्थर की मूरत बन जाते हैं। लेकिन क्या आपका दिल भी पत्थर का बना है? उसे मेरे प्रेम की न सही, मेरे इस धधकते यौवन की भी आंच नहीं लगती। और ये यौवन अंजूरी में धरे आपसे भीख मांगती हूं, फिर भी आप पिघलते नहीं। सिर्फ मेरा जन्म दास घराने में हुआ है तो क्या मुझे चुनाव का कोई अधिकार नहीं? मेरे इस धधकते यौवन को पानी की छींटे पाने तक का अधिकार नहीं? मेरे भाव में क्या सिर्फ देना ही देना है, पाना कुछ नहीं है? अधिकार नहीं चाहिए, सामाजिक सम्मान, धन, मांग में सिंदूर, मुझे वो सब कुछ नहीं चाहिए। मुझे सिर्फ अपना यौवन आपको समर्पित करना है और उससे जो प्रसाद मिलेगा उसे पाल पोस कर बड़ा करूंगी, अपने जीवन को सार्थक करूंगी। मुझे पता है मेरे जीवन की सार्थकता मेरा प्रश्न है, तुम्हारा नहीं। तुम दुनिया में सबसे निष्ठुर होने की अगर अगर रखी जाए तो तुम उसमें जरूर अव्वल होगे। गंधर्व सेन, अच्छा सुनो, तुम कहते हो कि पुरुष स्त्री के साथ संबंध सिर्फ तीन कारणों से रखता है, अपनी अपने वंश को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए, अपने एक अपनापन महसूस करने के लिए, और फिर काम पीड़ा को शांत करने के लिए। तो क्या इस सब में नारी का कोई मूलभूत अधिकार नहीं? अधिकार है गंधर्व से, एक नारी को अपने ऋतुकाल में ये अधिकार है कि वो योग्य पुरुष से पुत्रदान मांगे और उस पुत्र और उस पुरुष का ये धर्म है कि वो उसे पुत्रदान दे। मेरे लिए तुम योग्य पुरुष हो, पुत्रदान मेरा अधिकार है, तुम्हारा धर्म। क्या शर्मिष्ठा ने ययाति से ऐसा दान नहीं मांगा था? क्या राजा ययाति ने उसके साथ धर्म नहीं निभाया था? तो मैं तुम्हें संजीवनी दूं तब तुम शायद शायद मेरे साथ संभोग करोगे। तुम कितनी बेदर्दी से मेरा अपमान करते हो, कैसे तीखे बोल बोलते हो, लेकिन तुम्हें पाने के लिए मैं कुछ भी कर सकती हूं। अगर संजीवनी हाथ आ जाए तो वो भी दे दूं तुम्हें, पर संजीवनी हाथ लगेगी नहीं, इसलिए
so this is like this
is memories of old times.
yeah beautiful. So this is quite an intense moment in that otherwise quite farcical comic play, right? I wonder if you have any Gandhar sense in the in listening in. Must have been very, very nostalgic for them.
Yeah, there were parts of Gandharvasen that I had to kind of figure out how to deal with.
Yeah, you did that very cleverly. That was wonderful. You took it on to yourself. Wonderful. Okay, so that was Dubey's Sambhog Se Sanyasak, which in itself is an institution in the theatre lives of a lot of people. We're going to move on to Rajeshri. Rajeshri, are you on? Have you been able to solve your technical problems?
Yeah, so today what I'm going to be performing on Dubey's birthday for you is Nirmal Verma's Teen Ekant. It's a very well-known book. The book is about three monologues, three lonely people. The piece that I'm going to be performing today for you is called Weekend. It's about this woman who has a relationship with a married man, and it's a very mature and bold look. Outlook that she has towards the whole relationship, and I love this woman. I was given to do this piece when I was 19 by an accident, and I had to prepare it in a week's time. Didn't understand head or tail about the whole piece because it's a very mature piece. I understand it better now. I was in tears when Dwiji told me that I had to prepare it in 1 week. But he said ki kar lo tum, kitna bura karogi kar karke, kar hi logi kuch to. So it was a challenge, and I'm glad that it happened to me. I feel very fortunate, and I would like to perform this piece for you. Can I start? हम अपने वीकेंड हमेशा दूसरे शहर में गुजारते थे जो बहुत पास था. शनिवार इतवार जैसे नीचे रेल के पहिए केवल इन दो शब्दों को दोहराते हुए चक्कर काट रहे हों. कितनी अजीब बात है ना. बचपन में रेल के पहिए जिन शब्दों को दोहराते थे वे अब भी वैसे ही हैं. मरते हुए, ऊपर उठते हुए, फिर मरते हुए. नहीं, लेकिन मरता कोई नहीं. आखिर तक जाकर सब लौट आते हैं. हवा में उठा हुआ उसका संकेत भी नहीं जो एक जगह उठा रहता है, मुझे अपने पास बुलाता है और मैं भागती हूँ, उसके पास जाती हूँ. मैं यहाँ हूँ, यहाँ पार्क में. वो अपनी बच्ची से मिलने आया है. शाम तक वो खेलेंगे, मैं उन्हें देखूँगी. रात को हम लौटेंगे. हम लौटेंगे ये शब्द तसल्ली देते हैं. खुद खाली होकर भी मेरी खाली जगहों को भर देती है. इस बार मैंने उसे कहा था मैं बच्ची से मिलूंगी, उसे खेलते हुए देखूंगी. मैं उसे देखूंगी और वो जान भी ना पाएगी कि मैं वो हूं जो उसके साथ आई हूं. मैं वो हूं ये मेरे अलावा वहां कोई नहीं जान सकेगा, और तब उसे बुरा भी नहीं लगेगा कि मैं वो हूं पराई लड़की और वो किसी पराई लड़की के साथ अपनी बच्ची से मिलने आया है. ये मैं अब समझती हूँ. पहले मैं ऐसे नहीं थी, पहले मैं ज़बरदस्ती करती थी. हम कितने दिन ऐसे मिलते रहेंगे चोरों की तरह. चोर भी तो बाहर निकलते, तुम कोई फैसला क्यों नहीं करते, ना इधर ना उधर. वो आ रहा है अपनी बच्ची को लेके. हेलो. मैंने बच्ची की तरफ देख के मुस्कुराने की कोशिश की. वो मेरी कोशिश देखती रही, वो मुझे देखती रही, और तब मुझे हैरानी हुई कि बच्ची की उम्र चाहे छोटी ही क्यों ना हो, उसकी अपनी शर्तें हैं, और वो अपनी शर्तों पर उतनी ही आत्मनिर्भर और अकेली हैं जितनी यहां मैं. तुम ऊब तो नहीं गई? नहीं, मैं ऊब नहीं रही हूं. मैं मजे में हूं. आई एम गुड. या मैं सचमुच कितने मजे में हूं. ये दिन कितना खुला है, मैं कितनी खुली हूं. मैं कहीं भी जा सकती हूं, मेरे लिए सब कुछ खुला है. मेरे कोई बंधन नहीं है जैसे उसके हैं. एक छोड़ी हुई पत्नी, एक बंधी हुई बच्ची, और बीच में मैं खाली जगह को भरती हुई हवा की तरह जो हर सुने कोने में बसेरा कर लेती है. और जब फैलती हुई दुनिया उस खाली जगह को भरने का दावा करती है तो मैं कुछ भी नहीं कहती. मैं अपना बोरिया बिस्तर लेकर दूसरी तरफ चल देती हूँ. मैं फिर आऊँगी अगले हफ्ते वीकेंड पर, लेकिन इस समय मैं जा सकती हूँ अपने अकेले कमरे में. हम अगर अपने कमरे में हो, अपने बिस्तर पर रात गुजारी हो, तब मुश्किल नहीं पड़ती. तब आँख खुलते ही हम वहाँ से शुरू होने लगते हैं जहाँ पिछली रात खत्म हुई थी. लेकिन पराई कमरे में हर चीज़ ठिठकी रहती है. एक खाली फ्रेम, एक रफ ड्राफ्ट की तरह, सब कुछ अपने अपने बोझ के संग. इस वक्त मैं जा रही हूँ अपने कमरे में, अपने ठंडे अनछुए बिस्तर पर. मुझे उन दंपतियों से हमेशा हैरानी होती है जिन्हें एक दिन के बाद दूसरे दिन भी साथ रहना पड़ता है. वो कैसे उन भूरे रंग के खाली अंतरालों को जोड़ पाते होंगे जिनसे देह की उत्सुकता और पीड़ा उपजती है. नहीं, सोए हुए बिस्तरों की आत्मीयता मेरे लिए नहीं है। ये उन फैसलों की तरह हैं जिनसे परिवार बनते हैं। मेरे लिए वीकेंड है, अंधेरे में अलग अलग लैंप पोस्टों की तरह जलते हुए वीकेंड। इन्हें मुझसे कोई नहीं छीन सकता, ये मेरी वीकेंड है। थैंक यू।
जस्ट टू लेट पीपल नो, दिस वॉज द वीकेंड फ्रॉम तीन एकांत बाय निर्मल वर्मा, सीरीज ऑफ पीसेज ही रोट व्हेन ही वाज स्टडिंग इन प्राग फॉर ऑलमोस्ट 10 इयर्स। थैंक यू सो मच। या थैंक यू। All right, we're going to move on to Nina Kulkarni now. Nina, are you around? Can you hear us? Are you ready?
For... Yes, hello.
Yeah?
Hello, right. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you loud.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, hi, everybody.
Oh, you're looking gorgeous. Lovely, lovely. Okay. Yeah, well, so, Nina, what are you...
This is the character, not me today.
Okay. Well, nice character. What is this character?
Sunil, I was really confused between, I wanted to, you know how much I love Adi Adore and Binni there, and I wanted to do Savitri, and lekin, I don't know, bahut zyada wo, I didn't know the lines as well, and there was no time. And then I also wanted, thought of Mayavi Sarovar, then I thought of Aha, then I thought of Samosa Sanasa. I mean, you know, so much I've done with Dubai.
Too much choice. Yeah,
and eventually, choice. I, of course, zeroed in on my ever favorite player, that was Educating Beta. Firstly, because Dubai was there with me. I also thought of Abe Bevakoof, in which Dubai was there with me.
Yeah, yeah.
But I'm doing a piece from Educating Rita, finally. So this is my take on Rita. I know Neera Benegal is in the audience. Hi, Neera. She had done the costumes.
Yes, she had done the costumes.
In 1993, 1994. Yes, yes. Neera, I've just mixed and matched today just to, and because there was a red lipstick and all. So I said, let me just go back in time and do it. That's what I'm doing. I'm doing a piece from Educating Rita. Yeah. Because I, you know, this particular piece is a very relatable piece to any one of us. As a woman, as a girl, as a lady, as an old lady. It's a very relatable piece. And in the play also, it comes at a time. It's, I think, scene 7 in the first act.
Okay.
So it comes at a time. So it's a kind of a turning point in the play.
Right.
For people who don't know the play, I'll tell you that it is a two-act play with two characters. One is a professor who is, you know, at the... university, and there's this very brash, crash hairdresser who comes and she wants to learn. And it's the whole thing is about how she grows into it and how she starts knowing, which I want to know, that kind of thing. And Sunil, you remember the rehearsals of Educating
Rita?
Yes. And you know what crazy things I remember.
So, just to let people know, this play has a lot of inspiration from the idea of Pygmalion. Okay, so Frank is really professor who kind of, you know, grooms this young hairdresser who comes from a working class background.
Broadly.
I mean, yeah,
okay,
of course.
Of course, this is always a conversation since there are only two characters, but I'm trying to, Dubey is going to say something from up there, so I'm sure he'll say the lines. I've given him less lines.
Right.
Okay, so, So the scene is that, you know, Frank calls Rita over to his house on the weekend, thinking that now she's, you know, she'll be able to mix around and she's a great, lively character. And she doesn't turn up. And then he, of course, confronts her and she says this. I don't want to be charming and delightful. Funny. What's funny? I don't want to be funny. I want to talk seriously with the rest of you. I don't want to spend the night taking the piss, coming on with the funnies, because that's the only way I can get into the conversation. I didn't want to come to your house to play the court jester. I don't want to be me. Me. What's me? Some stupid woman who gives us all a laugh because she thinks she can learn, because she thinks that one day she can be like the rest of them. talking seriously, confidently, with knowledge, living a civilized life. Well, she can't be like that really, but bring her in because she's good for a laugh. Frank, I'm all right with you here in this room, you see? But when I saw those people you were with, I couldn't come in. I would have seized up. Because I'm a freak. I can't talk to the ones I live with anymore. And I can't talk to the likes of them on Saturday or those students out there because I can't learn the language. I'm half caste, that's what I am. I went back to the pub where Jenny was, and my mother, and Sandra and her mates. I decided I wasn't coming here again. I went into the pub and the song they'd learned from the jukebox. And I stood in that pub and thought, just what the frig am I trying to do? What the frig am I trying to do? Why don't I just pack it in and stay with them and join in with the singing? You think I can't, don't you, Frank? Just because you pass a pub doorway and hear the singing, you think we are all okay. We're all surviving with the spirit intact. Well, I did join in with the singing. I didn't ask any questions. I just went along with it. But when I looked around, my mother had stopped singing and she was crying. But no one could get it out of her why she was crying. So everyone just said that she was pissed and that we should get her home. So we did. And on the way, I asked her why. I said, "Why are you crying, mother?" And she said, because we could sing better songs than those. Ten minutes later, Denny had a laugh and then singing again, pretending she hadn't said it. But she had. And that's why I came back, Frank. And that's why I'm staying. I want to sing better songs. Okay.
That was beautiful. That was wonderful. Wow.
Thank you.
Wonderful. I mean, you know, one of the problems in this Zoom format is we can't even hear everybody's response to something. But honestly, I'm sure people just... you know, love this piece. It was beautiful.
Thank I hope so I didn't much. Miss out on anything, though.
No, it was lovely. It was lovely. And really, I mean, I think you were right. It just means a lot. I think it means a lot. All right.
It means a lot, yes.
Yeah, yeah. We all want to sing better songs. We all want to hear better songs. So I think it makes a lot of sense. You know, one of Dubey's very close collaborators was Professor Vasandev, who was a professor in a college in Viliparle East, professor of Hindi. And that collaboration with Vasandev led to some amazing translations of Marathi plays into Hindi, some amazing original writing by Dev Saab. We all know him as Dev Saab. And among the, you know, Dev Saab was beautifully culturally so grounded and so rooted. And he also had a very interesting language that he used. His Hindi was, you know, the kind of dialect that he used. He came from Madhya Pradesh and he used a particular local dialect which added so much, you know, color to the language. And one of the pieces he wrote was Sudama Ke Chawal. And we have Suhita Thatte here who worked on that piece as an actor. Dubey directed it. And Suhita, you would just like to say a little bit about it before you start off on Sudama Ke Chawal?
Sure.
Yeah, what are you going to, yeah, what's it about?
I did this play in 1994 with Dubey. Mm-hmm. And this play is very dear to me for various reasons. First one being, as you mentioned, it is written in Bundelkhandi dialect.
Right.
I was not familiar with at all. And I was going to perform with two actors who were familiar with the language. So that was a big challenge for me. Another very, very selfish reason was As Dubey's style was, he mostly had double cast for every part. But this was one play where he did not have a double cast for me. I was the only one who did the play that run. Okay. Third one being this character of Sudama's wife, Savitri, is very interesting. She is street smart. She is very open with what she wants in life. She has no qualms about seducing her husband to make him do what she wants him to do, and which is going to Shri Krishna and asking him for the riches. And her logic is, "Hum Brahman hai, bheek mangna apna dhanda dharam hai." So here it goes.
Okay.
Pandit, hum Brahman hai, bheek mangna apna dhanda dharam. यहाँ पे भीख मांगे कि वहां पे भीख मांगे कुछ फर्क पड़ता है काका? चीटा कहाँ जाए जहां गुड़ होए। साची बताओ पंडित, तुम्हें भंग प्यारी कि नाए? नाए तो रखो हमारे माथे पे हाथ और कहो कहो चांदी की गिलसिया, चांदी की गिलसिया तापे भंग हरी हरी दुधिया, एक गिलसिया सवेरे एक संझा के, तापे रबड़ी गाढ़ी लच्छेदार, वापे तमाकू खुशबोदार। कह दे नाय, नाय। अच्छा पंडित, मान लो आप भंग डांट के ब्रह्म टम्म में मगन होए के अपने डिंग बैठे हो, और हम सोला सिंगार करके लाल रेशम की महीन साड़ी पहन के ठुमक 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 चल के तुम्हारे ढींग आए, और यही हाथ से पिस्ता इलायची चिपकी मावे की गुजिया तुम्हारे मुखारविंद में टपकाए दे, तो क्या करोगे? छोड़ो हटो, बुढ़ाए गए पर बुरी आदतें ना गई, द्वारिका जी गए बिना गुजिया ना मिलेगी। चाची बताओ पंडित, कहो तो हम जाए द्वारिका जी। So Sudama goes to Dwarikaji after this, and he comes back without getting anything. And what he finds after coming home is not his home, but a palatial house, horses, elephants, the works. And he sees a woman. He does not recognize her. He falls at her feet. And she says, "Pandit, kya kar rahe ho? Log lugai tamasha dekh rahe hain. कुछ तो शर्म कीजिए, उठिए। हम आपकी धर्मपत्नी हैं, सावित्री हैं, यहाँ की महारानी हैं हम। पर श्री कृष्ण भगवान ने दिया है ये सब। तुम्हारी सौ हम अपने झोपड़े के बाहर बैठे थे, बैठे बैठे तुम्हें स्मरण कर रहे थे। का जाने राम का खाए रहे होंगे। इतने में पलक झपक गई और सामने ठाड़े द्वारकाधीश श्री कृष्ण भगवान, चार चार भुजा वाले, पीताम्बर धारे हुए, गले में वैजयंती माला पहने मंद मंद मुस्कुरा रहे थे। सो हम उनके सामने झुक गए। भगवान ने पीछे से हमें उठा लिया, हमारे माथे पे हाथ फेरा, हम भूख भूल गए। फिर प्रभु ने कही, का बहुत ही दुख पाया तूने, कारण के तेरा पति दो कौड़ी का, न कुछ काम का न धंधा व्यापार का, तू सती सावित्री, तू ही निभा सकी ऐसे दलित दर आदमी के साम। सो हम तुझको वरदान देते हैंगे, हम वरदान देते हैंगे कि तेरी मनोकामना पूरी होए। इत्ता कह के प्रभु ने पलकों पे हाथ फेरा, हम आँख खोली, तुम्हारी सब हम हो चखा, सारा जग बदला भय दिखा, बदन पे हमारे रेशमी साड़ी, सर पे शीश फूल, कान में झुमका, नाक में नथ, गले में मोहन माला, उंगली में मुंदरी, करधनी छड़ा, पायजे बिछिया, महल दो महला, हाथी घोड़ा, नौकर चाकर। हम सोचे खजाने राम सपना देख रहे, यही सब देखते रहे और भगवान को भूल गए। फिर सोचा सपना देख रहे, सोच चिकोटी काटी, हमने काटी चिकोटी। कहो पंडित कहाँ चले, कहा हमारी थूका पे चढ़ कर आओगे, हम देखते हैंगे महल के बाहर कैसे जाते होंगे, बहुत ही टिटर कराएंगे तो तहखाने में बंद करा देंगे। देखो पंडित ऐसे सस्ते में नाए छूट सकती होंगे, हम तुम्हें खुले महले में रखेंगे, तुम्हारे साम भक्तों का जमावड़ा रखेंगे, चारों बार हरे कृष्ण हरे राम की धुन जगावेंगे, तीर्थ प्रसाद बटवाएंगे, तुम्हारी खड़ाऊ गद्दी पे विराजमान कराए के राजपाट हम चलाएंगे, पूजोगे तुम भगत कहोगे, हम डौंडी पिटवा देंगे, पंडित जी श्री कृष्ण चरणारविंद के भ्रमर पद को पाए गएंगे, सुगुंजायमान हो रहे होंगे। सोच ले पछताना पड़ेगा। थैंक यू।
लवली, वेरी नाइस, एक्सलेंट, दैट वाज लवली।
थैंक यू, थैंक यू।
या Kumud Mishra used to play Pandit, Kumud, right?
Ashutosh
Rana, both. Ashutosh Rana also. They were all young, come straight out of NSD at that time. Yeah. Dubey had worked with them there. Yeah.
But you know something? I have done these shows, lots of shows with these two. But in my ears, Dubey's voice the resonance of his voice is still there. Saying this, the first speech.
Yeah.
Veda Sastra Sampanna Vidya Bhagi.
Correct. You should do it alone, the whole piece actually. Yeah.
Beautiful. Okay. Yeah.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Suhita. Lovely.
Thank you.
We move on. One day sitting at Prithvi, I think it was, Dubey summoned Arundhati Subramaniam and said, write me a piece, right? Which I want to do as a curtain raiser. You know, he loved doing curtain raisers. Before the main show started, he would love to do a piece so that people who had come on time have something to occupy themselves. And he asked Arundhati, and Arundhati, being a fantastic poet, wrote this beautiful piece, which Iravati, are you there? Which Iravati is going to actually do for us. Can you just talk about this, what you're going to do, Iravati?
Yeah. So, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah. So, this is a poem by Arundhati Subramaniam called The Ballad of the Backstage Worker. The year I started working with Dubey was also the year he contested the Lok Sabha elections as an independent candidate.
Yes, we remember that.
And yeah, and
you were his agent.
I was his chief election officer.
Oh my God. How old were you?
24, I think.
Okay.
And I organized press conferences for him, and it was insane. And just extremely, extremely frustrating as well, because I went to bed every night really frustrated, wondering what on earth all of this had to do with theater. And I would ask him that often. And then after a long, long time, he finally picked up this Croatian play by Miro Gavran called Death of an Actor. Mm. And Dubeji and Sonali Kulkarni were in it. And he said, Natak ke baare mein kuch karna hai, lo, karo. And he gave me this poem to perform as a curtain raiser before this show. So that's the poem that I'm going to read.
All right. Go right ahead.
Yeah. Who was it who built the Taj Mahal? You'd reply, why? Shah Jahan, of course. As for the Hanging Garden at Babylon, it's Nebuchadnezzar who gets all the applause. That's the way it's been since the dawn of time. The same hackneyed old story. For some of us, the blood, sweat, and tears. For others, the power and the glory. The cosmic playwright assigns each one a role. They say the world is but his stage. If you're lucky, you play hero or chorus or even fool. But some of us just have to stay cool. What then is our vocation? Our calling in life? Seek, they say, and you'll find it. A few get to be thespians, the stars of the scene. But most of us lurk behind it. We're consigned to the dustbins of history. Wasn't it Trotsky who said it? So Bacon and Marlowe work overtime while Shakespeare hogs all the credit. We hold the entire human opera together. It's a busy life out there in the wings. The actor may believe he's master of his fame, but we are the guys who pull the strings. The actor. Oh well, yeah. We allow him his tantrums since he's visited by the holy muse. Of course, whenever that deserts him on stage, we are there to prompt him with his cues. He's fragile, you see. An artistic genius. We treat him with infinite tact. We flatter him. We encourage his delusions, even the one about being able to act. The chap who looks despotic and dyspeptic all at once, like he's been entrusted with some divine mission, he calls himself the director, which essentially means he gets to play Stalin without an audition. Guarding his script like the sacred Turan is the writer, the playwright, who always seems vexed. If you change a comma, the poor man is convinced you've altered some subtle subtext. And if the status quo remains undisturbed, it's not because we lack a voice. For now, we've defended our mutiny. We've simply exercised a choice. Between the showman and the backstage subaltern, there exists an ancient transaction. The former gets a mention in the annals of history. We get to control all the action. Mind you, we hold no grudges. We apportion neither praise nor blame. But we know it can't be withheld much longer. Our 15 minutes of fame. Sit back now and turn off your mobiles. Watch the drama unfold. But don't forget, a far more exciting play is backstage, yet untold. We're plotting a bloodless coup, of course. A simple reversal of plight. One day, they'll find themselves in the shadows and we'll wake up in the spotlight. It's all Maya anyway, isn't it? Just a charade, a glorious deception. And if a vulgar ego trip is everyone's dream, well, I'm happy to remain the exception. So what if we don't get standing ovations? If we never get to sign an autograph? We don't need fairy godmothers to have a ball of our own, or even to have the very last laugh. So quite honestly, I'm rather relieved that it's time for me to depart. It's been hell memorizing this entire poem. Who wants to learn the bloody play by heart? That's it.
Lovely. Wonderful. Wonderful. Yeah. That Ira, you, it sort of came from your heart. I mean, it's like, you know. This is such a lovely poem. Arundhati, this is such a beautiful poem. And she knows it all, right? Because she was close to theater in her own time,
yeah,
right? I mean,
yeah.
So she's seen all the drama happening backstage, yeah, and everywhere.
And the poem is about theater, and Dubai is, I mean, synonymous, yeah, with the theater. So I thought I'd
do that. It's beautiful. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Lots of comments appreciating that, the poem and your performance. Great.
Thank you.
All right, we're going to move on and we're going to try something slightly more ambitious. We are overreaching ourselves, I don't know. But I'm going to request all of you to put yourselves on speaker view if you are on gallery view. Just go into speaker view because now we're going to do a piece from a play written by Dubey called Bekar Ke Bak Bak, which will be actually performed by two actors, Divya Jagdare and Krishna Patel. So, when they speak, the person who speaks will hopefully come on the screen. We'll just give it a shot. We've never done this before. We should have tried it out, but we didn't. So let's just hope it works out. Divya and Krishna, are you guys up for it?
Yeah.
Yeah? All right.
Let's go for it.
Okay. So let's go and put it onto speaker view if we can. Oh my God. Yeah. I'm on speaker view.
I can't see Divya, but that's okay.
I can't see Krishna.
Oh my God. See, this is complicated. Well, here's your chance, man. This is a challenge. Go for it, guys.
I can see you.
Yeah, go for it. Oh, there you are now. Okay.
I see you, Divya. Yes.
You can. I can't see you. Okay. Should I try or I should continue?
Continue,
Divya. Carry on.
Continue. It's okay. Go with the sound cues.
Do we have to say anything or we can just start?
Well, you want to talk about why. Can you talk about why you... Oh my God, there's something. Somebody has got their mic on. Just switch it off, please.
Prashant, put it on.
Yeah, okay. Thank you, Prashant. Prashant. Oh my God. All right. Okay. So, So Divya, you want to just talk very briefly about why you decided to do this piece, Bekar Ki Bak Bak in London, right? That's what the play is called.
Yeah.
Bekar Ki Bak Bak in London. Okay. Tell us about it.
Yeah, so you know, Dubey ji was never around during the rehearsals. He had gone away to London. And well, you know, those were the days when I was getting cast in every Dubey play. So I ended up doing this one also. And the second half of this play was not written. He had gone away to London, I remember. And I was just telling Hidayat that he had sent a few pages of the script, the second half of the script from London to us, with notes scribbled on it, how we should make the changes into, you know, sit down here and stand there. And he was so finicky about minor details. And, you know, I could literally imagine that he's not sleeping over there. He's just penning the lines there and he sent it to us in a huff and with all right. notes scribbled and all that stuff. So the reason why I think Trishla and I, also we are neighbors, you know, so it was easy for us to kind of do a rehearsal. So that's right. one of the reasons. And secondly, it's a fun thing. It's like... We had a ball during Bekar Ki Bakbak because Dubey ji was never around. And it used to be Kumud, Manav, Trishla and me just continuously rehearsing lines. And I think all of Dubey ji's teachings must have consolidated in our heads at that time. Isn't it, Trishla?
Yeah. He said, Tumhare jo bure adat hai, tum Makran sir ki actor ban gayi ho, Sunil Sharma ki actor ban gayi ho. I have to break your bad habits.
It was really fun and it was very light and Dubey ji was not there. We opened this in Bhopal and we went in the train. I remember it was mad fun. So that's why we kind of both of us decided.
Good enough reason to do this. Go right.
Yeah, bilkul. Absolutely. So Trishla, I can see you.
Okay.
Devika ka flat, Manna ka pravesh. कुछ गुनगुना रही है कुछ लेकर आई है
ये शामें सब की सब शामें क्या इनका कोई अर्थ नहीं
मंदा कहाँ गई थी
कहीं नहीं
से क्या मतलब
बस ऐसे ही
तेरे को हजार बार कहा है बाहर जाकर तो नोट छोड़ के जाया कर पहली बार लंदन आई है ना तू
दीदी पानी
सुन दोबारा फोन तो नहीं आया त्रिवेदी काका का
नहीं दीदी
ये त्रिवेदी काका भी बस एकदम झक्की है बैठे बैठे एक झंझट खड़ी कर दी अब कहां खोजने जाऊं उनको
मैं कैसे बता सकती हूँ दीदी
ओ शट अप बंदा एकदम घोंचू है तू सुन पहली बार फोन किया था तो एयरपोर्ट से किया था ना
हाँ दीदी उन्होंने तो फोन पर ये भी कहा था कि बस लगेज के लिए रुके हैं
तो फिर कहाँ चले गए तो यहाँ आने की बात कही थी ना पते वगैरह का कोई कंफ्यूजन तो नहीं था
उनको पता अच्छी तरह मालूम था दीदी उन्होंने तो यहाँ तक कहा कि आपका और धर्माधिकारी जी का फ्लैट एक ही बिल्डिंग में है
तो अभी तक पहुंचे क्यों नहीं
मुझे क्या मालूम दीदी अच्छा तो धर्माधिकारी जी के यहाँ भी नहीं पहुंचे त्रिवेदी काका
अगर पहुंचे होते तो तेरे साथ ये बेकार की बकबक क्यों कर रही होती एकदम स्टूपिड है तू
हाँ दीदी
की बच्ची एक ड्रिंक बना कर ला
जी
ड्रिंक
दीदी
यस ड्रिंक दीदी वांट्स अ ड्रिंक
पर दीदी
दीदी की बच्ची ड्रिंक लाने को कहा ना
कहा
तो
पर आपने तो 5 साल से छोड़ रखा है
तो दोबारा शुरू नहीं कर सकती
हाँ कर क्यों नहीं सकती पर अच्छी बात नहीं है
मैंने सलाह मांगी तुझसे
नहीं दीदी पर मांगती तो मैं यही कहती
देख मंदा मुझे जरूरत सलाह की नहीं एक ड्रिंक ही है जाके ला
घर पर शराब नहीं है दीदी
तो जाकर बाजार से ला
लंदन के रास्ते ठीक से मालूम नहीं मुझे
लंदन गाइड बुक ला के दी थी ना
दीदी आप दोबारा ड्रिंक शुरू करेंगी तो फिर कभी छोड़ नहीं पाएंगी
मंदा प्लीज तूने मुझे अभी ड्रिंक नहीं दी ना तो मैं प्लीज मंदा किसे फोन कर रही है किसे फोन कर रही है
धर्माधिकारी जी को
क्यों
शायद उनके यहाँ ड्रिंक हो
फोन नीचे रख उस बदतमीज का तो नाम भी मत ले ड्रिंक तो वो क्या देगा लेक्चर जरूर पिलाएगा ये हिंदुस्तान नहीं इंग्लैंड है आप यहाँ रात बिरात फोन करके ड्रिंक बोरो नहीं कर सकते और छाती ठोक के कहता है
थोड़ी भी डिसेंसी नहीं. He was totally pissed, that bastard. मैं इंग्लैंड का नागरिक हूँ, एशियाई लोगों से कन्नी काटता हूँ, भारतीयता के ठेकेदारों से भी. मुझे तो दया आती है इंग्लैंड पर. ऐसे लोगों को सिटीजनशिप देता रहा ब्रिटेन तो बंटाधार समझो अंग्रेजों का. मंदा, ए मंदा, मंदा मंदा, अरे वो हमको वो एक पैकेट मिला था ना मिनी बॉटल्स का प्लेन में. हाँ वो, अरे याद है वो, अरे वो जो पर्सर, चीफ पर्सर तुझसे और मुझसे साइमल्टेनियसली फ्लर्ट कर रहा था, उसने हाँ. मिनी बॉटल्स का पैकेज भेजा था ना, दिया था ना उनको, कहाँ गया वो
पता नहीं.
क्या पता, अरे वो सूटकेस में होगा. सूटकेस में क्या?
देविका अंदर से सूटकेस घसीट कर लाती है और उसे खोलती है, मिनी बॉटल्स नहीं मिलती.
तो बाथरूम में होगा. मैंने ना उसे 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 पैकेट में डालकर बाथरूम में रख दिया था. लेके आ मंदा.
ब्लैकआउट एंड सीन.
थैंक यू.
Lovely. Thank you. Oh, okay. You know, this is a play I don't know very well, so it's quite a pleasant surprise for me. This was the period when I was trying to kind of keeping away. If you were doing the strange plays and, you know, traipsing around the world and oh God, yeah. Yeah. Lovely. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And it worked quite well to have both of you there. I mean, you came on and off. Yeah.
Is it?
The sound was good. Yeah, it was good. It was good. Okay. Yeah, it was fun.
Great. Yeah.
Yeah. It'd be like, look, there are lots of comments saying the people enjoyed it. Very nice.
Okay.
So I think it was in 2004 or a little earlier than that. Dubey had gone to Nashik for some award ceremony. He was being given an award. And there was a young actress there who went up to him and said, you know, Dubey, I'd like to work with you. Can I come to Bombay and work with you? And he, of course, completely, you know, dismissed. He said, ridiculous. You'll be lost if you come to Bombay. Don't even waste your time. Stay here in Nashik and do what you have to do. And sometimes Dubey could be quite hard about these things. But this young girl said, no, I'm going to do that. I'm going to go to Bombay and work. And she landed up in Bombay and started working with Avishkar, which is a very famous theater company. And Dubey used to spend a lot of time at Avishkar. And that's where they met up again. The young actress is Anita Date. And she actually didn't work with Dubey for a while. In fact, she avoided Dubey and he would sort of, you know, laugh at her because she was so, you know, trying to keep out of his way. But Dubey was doing a workshop with the actors at Avishkar and he put together a play called Tham Lakshmi Kumkum Laute. Okay. This is a line taken from a very famous Marathi melodramatic sentimental film, Tham Lakshmi Kumkum Laute. And it was a kind of a crazy play. He was going through that phase actually where everything that concerned him, everything that kind of piqued his interest that was happening around him would go into a play. And this was also the time of the daily soap. So Ekta Kapoor was very much on his mind. And, you know, actors had this strange thing about Ekta Kapoor, no? Theater actors. They all want to work with Ekta Kapoor at the same time. Do you want to do that kind of soap? You know, so he picked on that. And Anita saw Tham Lakshmi Kumkum Laute. And she loved the madness of the script. So when we asked her what she'd like to do, she said, I'd like to do a piece from that. Anita is working very hard somewhere in the outskirts of Igatpuri, shooting a Marathi television series. And so she sent a video. In fact, it came just today. And we're going to actually run that. Oh my God. I'm completely exposed, aren't I?
Kambhakto. लक्ष्मी हूं मैं, लक्ष्मी. अरे बेवकूफ हो, विष्णु की पत्नी हूं मैं. एक्सपेरिमेंटल थिएटर के बिलबिले चिलबिले कीड़ों नहीं छोड़ोगे इस दिन. वो जटाधारी शिव की पूजा करोगे और भूखे मरोगे सबके सब. कभी भी मार्केट को, इकोनॉमी को फूलने फलने नहीं दोगे. बे इंसाफी का नारा लगाते हो दिन रात. ऐसी कौन सी बे इंसाफी हुई है तुम्हारे साथ? बे इंसाफी तो मेरे साथ हुई है. उस नारद के बच्चे ने मुझे श्राप दिया था, याद है ना? भूल गए? अरे अपना वो फटीचर एक्सपेरिमेंटल नाटक ब्रह्मा विष्णु महेश, उस नाटक में सरस्वती ने और नारद ने चापलूसी करके मुझे श्राप दिया था. कलमोही मेरी सौर तथा तू बोलने से भी हिचकी नहीं वो. और वो कलयुग में कालमास बनके पैदा हुआ, ओवर एक्टिंग करता था. लबाड़ हरामखोर, उन लोगों ने मुझे शाप दिया था तुम्हें कभी भी संतान नहीं होगी, लेकिन मैंने दत्तक पुत्र अपनाए, आज वो सब दुनिया पे राज कर रहे हैं, अमेरिका, जापान, इटली, कालमास को पूजने वाला रशिया, चाइना, हिंदुस्तान भी लाइन पे आ गया है, टाटा, बिरला, रिलायंस, मित्तल, इनकी तूती बोल रही है। इतना ही नहीं, मैंने फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर को भी अपना लिया, दत्तक ले लिया, और एकता कपूर को भी। तुम्हारे धंधे में वो मेरी सबसे फेवरेट है, उसके पास जाओ, पैसा कमाओ और मेरे गुणगान गाओ, मुझसे सीखो उल्लू पर सवार होना, नहीं तो पीसे जाओगे, रौंद दिए जाओगे। चलो मुझे दुबई जाना है। थाम लक्ष्मी, कुंकू लाते हैं, कुंकू, ये तो वो मराठी फिल्म की ट्रिक है, उसने कुंकू की परंपरा को अपना लिया और खुद कुएं में जाके जान दे, कुंकू लगा लेती तो उसकी इच्छा पूरी करती है। लेकिन एक्सपेरिमेंटल नाटकों पे थूकती हूं मैं, मेरे अस्तित्व को नकारने की जरूरत करते हैं, उनको दिखाई नहीं देता, समझ नहीं सकते, कफन भी नसीब नहीं होगा,
मेरे अखबारों में तुम्हारी ओबिचुरी नहीं छपेगी,
नहीं छपेगी, गुड बाय।
That was Lakshmi in Tham Lakshmi Kumkum Laute, Anita Date, all the way from Igatpuri, from some hotel room. Thank you so much, Anita. We miss you having here. She said she would try and log in if she had network, but they're in some remote areas, so I don't know if she's there, but thank you so much. And yeah, so we are now to the last piece of the evening. I hope everybody's been with it. We have Ratna here, Ratna Pathak Shah. Both Ratna and Naseer, in fact, have been very, very old associates of Dubey. Ratna, of course, well before, parents were great friends of Dubey. Dubey spent a lot of time at their place. In fact, that's the first time I met Dubey, was at Ratna's place, where he walked into the room one afternoon and he said, Ratna, beta, I've just come from Pune. I need some serious reading. Where are your comic books? So, you know, that was my first introduction to Dubey. Yeah. So Ratna and Naseer did a lot of work with Dubey, and one particular play that was a very powerful play and which both of them worked in was Antigone. So Ratna, would you like to sort of, you know, just tell us a little bit? Oh, there you are. Hi, Ratna. Lovely to have you. Yeah. And do your piece. Go right ahead.
So remembering Dubey, I do that every day practically. Dubey cast me in Antigone when I was 50. I think he was trying to do a Shaw. Shaw cast Mrs. Campbell for Eliza Doolittle, a teenager, when she was 48. So Dubey thought, I could do better than that. I'll cast Ratna at 50 as Antigone, again, a child. But I did it, and I loved every minute of it. So I'm going to do a piece out of that for you. the bare bones of the play, for those who don't know it, Antigone and Ismene are Oedipus's daughters. Oedipus, he who killed his father and married his mother, Oedipus. So Oedipus's daughters. Oedipus had two sons, Eteocles and Polynices, who both were supposed to jointly rule the kingdom after Oedipus's death. Of course, Eteocles refused to step down after his year was over. And so the brothers fought each other. There was a civil war. Both brothers died, impaled on each other's swords in single combat outside the city walls. Creon, the king's brother-in-law, decided to bury with great pomp and honor the body of Eteocles and leave the body of Polynices out there to rot outside the city gates. His stench filled the town. Antigone decides to bury her brother, and she does. She is caught, she is brought in front of Creon. There's a long argument. Creon tries very hard to convince her, offers to hush up everything, if only she will do what she's told, and convinces her that her brothers were absolute bastards and they deserved what they got, and tries to finally play his last card, which is that she should marry, have children, live a happy life. Because after all, life is only the happiness that you can get from it. Antigone asks, happiness? What sort of happiness do you foresee for me? Paint me the picture of your happy Antigone. Tell me, what are the unimportant little sins that I must commit if I am to be able to sink my teeth into life and tear happiness from it? To whom shall I have to lie? Whom do I fawn over? To whom must I sell myself? Whom do you want me to leave dying while I turn away my eyes? Why do you ask me to be quiet when all I want to know is what I have to do in order to be happy? This minute, because it is this very minute that I must make my choice. You tell me life is so wonderful. I want to know what I have to do in order to be able to say so myself. You ask me if I love Haman. Yes, I love Haman. The Haman I love is hard and young, faithful, difficult to satisfy, just as I am. But if what I love in Haman is to be worn away like a stone step by the tread of that thing you call life, the thing you call happiness, if he too has to learn to say yes to everything, then no. No. I know I do not love Haman. And I do know what I'm talking about, Creon. It is you who have stopped understanding. You know, I suddenly see you, Creon, as you must have been when you were 15. The same look of impotence on your face, the same inner conviction that there is nothing you can't do. What has life added but the lines on your face? Do you think I don't see in your face that you know what I am saying is true? You have to refuse, I suppose. You have to go on groveling like a dog over a bone. But you know I am true. Happiness. I spit on your happiness. I spit on your idea of life. That life must go on, come what may. You are all like dogs that lick everything they smell. You with your promise of a humdrum happiness, provided a person does not ask too much of life. But I want everything of life. I do. And I want it now. I want it total. I want it complete. Otherwise, I reject it. I want to be sure that everything will be just as beautiful as it was when I was a little girl. Otherwise, I want to die. And I will scream in my father's own voice, Creon. I will scream that we belong to the tribe that asks questions. and we ask them to the bitter end. So go on, call your guards. Call in your guards. Go on, show a little courage. It only hurts for a minute. Call in your guards. Go on.
Oh, that was beautiful, wonderful.
Thank you.
What a powerful piece. I mean, it just takes me right back. It's such a powerful piece, such a powerful piece. Yeah.
Yes, it is.
Thank you. And thank you so much. Yeah.
Dubey was not his own self, I have to say. When we were doing it, Dubey was tired.
He was tired. He was not very well. Yes.
He was not at all well.
Yeah.
For the first time, he was short of ideas about the set. I mean, Dubey always knew exactly what he wanted,
yeah,
except about performances.
Sure.
There he was so sure.
Yeah.
And he didn't have the madness to push us as he used to. But it was a wonderful way to say goodbye to Dubey.
I know.
Antigone.
I know. That was actually the beginning of his seizures, and it all began at that time. And it was, you know, from then onwards, it was really...
It was all downhill.
Yeah. And he fought and he stayed and he, you know, he just... But there was a lot of denial.
Oh, yes.
And, yeah, I know. But that's why I think it was so fitting in a sense that Antigone, in a sense, was really the peak of that particular period. So thank you so much for sharing that with us. It was beautiful.
Thank you for having me, and thank you for organizing this. This is fantastic.
This is beautiful. You know, actually, it wasn't so bad online. I mean, you know, we ran into glitches and we are little, you know, not so good with our fingers, but we'll figure it out. And I think, you know, I think this, we can do some stuff with this.
Yeah.
I mean, it can never be the same. Of course, it can't be the same. And it's ridiculous even to expect that. But yeah, this was still nice. So we come to the end of this wonderful evening. Thank you all very much, all the actors, actresses, for sharing your experiences, your amazing skills, your stories. Thank you so much. I think most people here have been completely, you know, blown by the quality of the stuff that you have, you know, presented to us this evening. And the fact that it comes from such a warm place in your hearts really makes a difference. Thank you very much. And of course, thank you very much for the wonderful people who all stayed and, you know, for almost an hour and a half and been part of this. Thank you very much. We're going to try one more experiment. We're going to do a small little technical thing where all of them will appear on the screen together as all 11 of them. And I will request Achal, who has so ably assisted us, Achal Poddar, who has been assisting us with the logistics and the technical stuff, and Hidayat Sami, who's, you know, very much part of this evening, who actually put all this together, to unmute everybody. So let's try and get an applause from currently 226 people, and maybe we'll... Maybe we'll...
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Don't sound like they're applauding a theater at all. So much. Thank you. Good night. Good night. And let's hope we can get back into the theater soon and resume our passion in life. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Ali Malika.